Have you ever wanted an easy way to remove noise from your microphone? I'm talking about the air noise or static noise that can be disrupting for a listener. In this video, we're going to show you how to set up NVIDIA's noise removal so you can start sounding better today. Depending on the type of graphics card that you have installed on your computer will change how you enable this feature. If you have a GTX card like I do myself, which is a graphics card that was released before the RTX series cards, which is the 20 and 30 series cards from NVIDIA, then you'll need to download the RTX voice application. If you have an RTX card, you'll need to use the NVIDIA broadcast application, which has NVIDIA noise removal built into that app. Unfortunately for this video, I won't be able to show you the RTX version of the setup. However, the settings are exactly the same. So what you need to do is download the NVIDIA broadcast app and just follow along with the same steps with the microphone settings. Both of these downloads are linked in the description below. Once you have them downloaded, we can start with the setup process. Once you run the download, this will pop up. We're gonna go ahead and agree to the software license, and then it will start installing NVIDIA RTX Voice. After you have it installed, go ahead and click close. After you do that, NVIDIA RTX Voice will open up. What we're gonna do is select our input device, which is gonna be the microphone that you use currently. It could be an onboard microphone, it could be the laptop device, whatever it is, make sure you select that device here. The next step is quite simple. All you're gonna do is toggle on this remove background noise from my microphone, and this will start removing the noise from that mic. You can adjust the percent of the noise suppression so that you can get it sounding just right. In order to do this properly, we'll need some way to monitor ourselves so that we can hear what we sound like as we adjust the noise suppression level in RTX Voice. What I suggest doing is setting up an app called Voice Meter. This will allow you to set up your microphone within Voice Meter so that you can listen to it as you speak into the mic. If you don't want to use Voice Meter, what you can do is do a recording using Streamyard and listen back to yourself as you adjust the levels within RTX Voice until you get it just right. All right, now that we're at Voice Meter, what I'm gonna do is set this source from my microphone over to the new NVIDIA RTX Voice that gets created. Now, what I'm gonna do is listen to myself as I adjust the settings. I'm gonna enable the noise removal, and I'm gonna slide this up until I like how it sounds. Now that we have the noise removal level set, we're gonna head over to Streamyard and make sure we have our RTX Voice microphone source set up within Streamyard so that every time we use Streamyard, the noise removal is also being used. Within our Streamyard broadcast, what we're gonna do is head over to cam and mic settings. From there, we're gonna go to audio and we're gonna make sure that we have the RTX Voice microphone source selected. I also want to note, it might be easier for you to go into your system settings and set that RTX Voice source as the default device on your computer so that every application that you download will have that as its source on default. And you can also set the input device to default on any application that you use. So that might help you as well, just an additional bit of information as far as the setup goes. But you will need to make sure you set up that RTX Voice input source on every app that you use if you don't do that. So just be mindful of that. You won't have noise suppression unless you are selecting that source as your input device on the apps that you use. Now you've successfully set up noise removal for your streams with Streamyard. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you leave a like and subscribe to this channel for more content like this. We've got a lot of awesome videos planned for you guys, so make sure you stay tuned. If you guys have any questions after watching this video, if any of the steps were confusing for you, make sure you leave a comment down below and I'll do my best to answer those questions as thoroughly as possible. Again, thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video. Peace.